made up 65% to 70% of our prison population is African American now. And if you look at the federal prisons and people who are in federal prisons for nonviolent drug offenders, it's 85% of nonviolent drug offenders that are in federal prisons are African Americans. And this is because this war on drugs, and what my concern is because of the whole issue of privatization of prison as well.
Speak to that.
Coming right alongside of this, okay, we're arresting all the drug dealers, and of course the drug dealers an African American, which we know they're not, and they're not arrested anymore. You know, they're looking for the African American drug dealer, but they still can't, they can't
they're
find him,
a
right?
Small
because
proportion of the population,
right, they're still only having the arrest rate of 25 to 30%, but they've got all these police officers looking for him, they can't find him. So obviously that's not who's dealing drugs and not who's using them. But then at the same time, you got these disparities in arrest versus incarceration rates, which it should be like this, but it's not. You've got privatization of prison. So you've got all these prisons opening up, and one in particular is opening up in, or has opened up, just in Northern Virginia, that used to be one of the largest slave plantations back in the 1800s in the United States. And they're taking all the prisoners from Washington, D.C., which primarily it's going to be about 90% African American, and putting them in that prison in Virginia, which used to be slave plantation, land. And they're doing, they're in private prison doing labor for free. On this, in this private prison in Virginia, African American males who are in there for non-violent drug offenses.
Now, this has also been a part of the system in the state of Tennessee as well, has it not? The private penal systems and an effort on the part of some people to increase their numbers. Is that true in reference to your state here?
Right. Correctional Corporation of America is probably one of the biggest prison systems, and we have a Correctional Corporations is here in Nashville, off of Harding Place, and they are housing a lot of inmates. And the reason why people are voting for and agreeing with and not screaming about this privatization of prison looking a lot like slavery is because it's coming under the umbrella of, well, it's saving the taxpayers money. And we don't want to pay taxes to keep people locked up. So if the private prison can do it cheaper, let them do it. But what they don't understand is the private prisons are incarcerating people for profit. And they're going into these prisons and they're making clothing and they're booking your airline flights and they're getting credit card information off of people who are calling in to buy things. And prisoners are, you know, they're on the phone booking your airline flight and getting your credit card information. You know, which isn't a big concern to me because they're not going to do anything with
and
that information.
This is still exploitation of labor.
But that's my concern is not that they're getting information and it's that they're doing labor, making profit for corporations, and
which use them to expand the system itself and more.
Right.
Yeah. It's yeah. It's,
and
it's,
if you're incarcerating people for profit, then you're gonna want to put more and more people in prison. You're not gonna want to solve crime. You're gonna want to lock people up.
That's what the profit motive is all about.
Right.
Yes. Very good. And of course, we're nearing the end of this second segment here, Dr. Burris Kitchen. And when we come back, we want to talk about some other aspects of overpopulation and overrepresentation of Africans and not only Africans, but as you indicate, people of color in the criminal justice system. And I think that we can really say from what you've already said in reference to it is that we are ripe for reform. If there was ever any kind of reform that could be a part of the system, certainly this would be the time that we could deal with the kind of reform that is necessary. And so when we come back, we want you to deal with some of those issues. And we'll be back with our audience following this very, very short commercial break.